In this lecture, we will discuss about genomics and human genome project. So what do you understand by this term genomics? So genomics is a molecular biology concerned with the structure, function, evolution and mapping of the genomes. So genomics, we can say, is the study of whole genome of an organism, or we can say it is an area within genetics that concern the sequencing and analysis of an organism genome. This term introduced by H. Winkler in 1920, that is the total genetic constitution of an organism. Alternatively, it is a complete copy of genetic information, that is DNA, or one complete set of chromosome, monoploid or haploid, of an organism. The term genomics, it was coined by T.H. Roderick in 1986, and it is the study of genome through analysis, sequencing and mapping of genes along with the study of their function. The sequencing of yeast, Drosophila and mouse, their genome was done in order to facilitate the comparative studies between human and other organisms commonly used for genetic study in laboratory. If we'll see here genomics, the study may be classified into two types, that is structural genomics and functional genomics. So what is structural? It involves the mapping, sequencing and analysis of the genome, whereas functional, it deals with the study of function of all the gene sequence and their expression in the organisms. Now, what is the applications of genomics? So, structural and functional genomics, that is used for different purpose in the improvement of crop plant, human health and livestock. The knowledge and understanding acquired from genomics research can be applied in a number of different sectors, including medicine, then biotechnology and social science. It also helps in the treatment of genetic disorder through the gene therapy. Genomics is used in agriculture to develop transgenic crops having more desirable characters. Genetic markers which develop in genomics, they have the application in forensic analysis. Genomics can lead to introduce new gene in microbes to produce enzyme, your therapeutic protein and even biofuels. Now next is Human Genome Project. All of us, we know that Human Genome Project is related with the sequencing and determining all the genes which are present in human being. Now, much of us earlier, we used to be very much curious about the genes. So, as because of that, Human Genome Project came into existence. Now, what was the difficulty in Human Genome Project? That no two individuals except twins are identical on the earth. So, every individual is little bit different from another, and much obvious, if at all morphologically that individual is different, definitely gene wise also it will be different. So, as this the particular force of action, so as to determine as HGP in case of human being, and for that this HGP, which was the mega event or mega project, was undertaken by different countries. Different countries, they contributed in it. Much obvious here, unfortunately, India was not a part of it. Here, the Human Genome Project, it was initiated in 1990, and this project was coordinated by the US Department of Energy and National Institute of Health. The Human Genome Project began in 1990 and was completed in 2003. So it was completed in 13 years. Human Genome Project, it is a multinational research project to determine the genomic structure of humans. Now, what are the main aim of this project? Or we can say, what are the goals of this Human Genome Project? So the main goal is what? To identify all the genes for human DNA. Identify various genes which are causing genetic disorder. Yes, or to determine the genetic immunity to the various disorder. Like, can we have any such immunity of this genetic disorder, or can we have the replacement of the gene, or can we keep such particular gene in inactive form? So all that stuff related to this goal. Now the first aim is mapping the entire human genome at the level of nucleotide sequence. Or we can say to determine the sequence, that is around 3 billion chemical base pairs. So it was observed, well, before that there were 3 billions of base pair in human gene, that is total gene 3 billions. Now next is what? To store the information collected from the project in database. So if at all we will keep on writing the sequence ATGC ATGC in book, it will have been like tedious job. It will not be so fruitful. So as much obvious, the decision was taken to put that all this information in the form of computer language. Now next is to develop the tools and technique for analysis of the data. So improved tools for the data analysis and handling the 3 billions of chemical base pair is not a joke. Yes, and that is why America and European country, they started improving their tools for data analysis, and that various kinds of machinery have been put, the computers were upgraded and all that stuff. Now next is transfer of the related technologies to the private sector, such as industries. Yes, so here transfer related technologies to other sectors. So that is so and so of the gene combination for so and so gene. So we can say we'll able to use that gene combination in industry. So for example, production of various kind of proteins or various kind of enzymes or various kind of hormone level treatment, etc. in the industries. Now next is taking care of legal, ethical and social issues which may arise from projects. So there were several issues and handled carefully. So here Human Genome Project, it took 13 years to complete and completed in 2003. The extended version or the last contribution was given in 2006 fruitfully, and these are the aims. Now HGP was closely associated with rapid development of a new area in biology called as bioinformatics. Now the work of Human Genome Project was allowed researchers to begin to understood the blueprint in building and constructing the human genome. As researchers, they learn more about the function of gene and the proteins. Their knowledge will have major impact in the field of medicine, in biotechnology field and life science. Therefore, this HGP is very important. Human Genome Project was to provide complete and accurate sequence of the 3 billion DNA base pair and make up the human genome, and to find out the estimate number of human gene. Now about 33,000 genes have been estimated to be present in human. The secret of our complexity may lie not in the number of our gene, but how we use them. It will lead to understanding of gene structure and function in other species. Since we possess many of the genes, same as flies, roundworm and mice, so such studies will be lead to a greater understanding of human evolution. Now here We can see this comparative genome size of human and other organisms. So here in some organisms like human being and mouse, fruit fly, then plants, then roundworm or yeast or bacteria. So here these organisms are given, and in that their chromosome number is different. Human 46, then mouse is 40, fruit fly, Drosophila is 8, then Arabidopsis, this plant, 10, then roundworm, 12, yeast, 32. So these are what the chromosome number, and here these are the estimated gene number, and this is the estimated size, base pair size. Now let's see the salient feature of Human Genome Project. The human genome contains 3164.7 million nucleotide base pair. Yes, the size of the gene varies. An average gene consists of 3000 base pair, while the largest gene, dystrophin, consists 2.4 million bases. Yes, if we'll see the total number of gene is estimated to 30,000, and 99.9% of the nucleotide are the same in humans. Now the function of over 50% of the discovered gene is still not known, unknown. Only less than 2% of the genome codes for protein. Another 98% genes, what they are doing, we still don't know. Now, repeated segments form large portion of human genome. So why? That still we don't know, ki why this repeated segments are formed. Now next, repeated segments, they throw light on chromosome structure and dynamics and evolution. Through, they are thought to have no direct coding function. Chromosome number 1 has 2968 genes, and Y chromosome has the least number, 231 genes only. So 1 mostly 2968, and Y has fewest, that is 231 gene only. The scientists have identified about 1.4 million locations where DNA differs in single bases in human being. These are called as single nucleotide polymorphism. And the repeated sequence, they make up a large portion of human genome. And only 2% of genes, they are coding for the proteins. So this is about the features of Human Genome Project. Now let's see applications of Human Genome Project, like identification of human genes and their function. Next, understanding of polygenic disorder, for example cancer, hypertension and diabetes. If we say cancer, then how this cancer gene can be eliminated or how they can be suppressed. Then improvement in gene therapy, then improved diagnosis of diseases and development of pharmacogenesis, that is medicinal drugs. So in this way, some more applications, like the study of tissues, like can we get some unique proteins from the tissues, that research is going on it. So it will be very fruitful in future for getting genetically based improvements. So in this way, we had studied about the Human Genome Project, and now in next lecture we will discuss about DNA fingerprinting.